The U.S. Air Force, in cooperation with the Department of Energy's National Nuclear Security Administration, NNSA, has completed the first end-to-end qualification flight test of the new B-6112 nuclear gravity bomb on the B-2 bomber. On June 29th, in an official press release, the National Nuclear Security Administration revealed two successful test flights were carried out. The U.S. Air Force Brigadier General Michael Lutton, NNSA's Principal Assistant Deputy Administrator for Military Application, said in a statement, "These qualification flight tests demonstrate the B-6112 design meets system requirements and illustrate the continued progress of the B-6112 life extension program to meet national security requirements." As per the report, on the 9th of June, a B-2A Spirit bomber from the Air Force's 419th Test and Evaluation Squadron flew from Edwards Air Force Base in California and dropped the bomb with an inactive warhead on the Tonopah Test Range. The U.S. military expects the B-6112, also known as the B-61 Mod 12, to replace all existing versions of B-61. That's the B-61 3, 4, 7, and 11 in the active stockpile. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes the capabilities of the new B-6112 nuclear gravity bomb. Let's get started. The B-6112 is a cooperative effort between the Air Force and NNSA. The U.S. Air Force is responsible for acquiring the Boeing-designed GPS-assisted inertial navigation system, INS, directed tail kit. The kit has tail fins to control the bomb's downward descent and will enable it to dive down on the target with high accuracy. The bomb also uses rockets in the main body to spin-stabilize it in flight and improve its accuracy. NNSA is responsible for developing the bomb's main assembly and integrating the actual nuclear warhead on live weapons. The bomb's exact power remained classified. Some reports indicate the warhead will have a maximum yield of approximately 50 kilotons. To give viewers a perspective, here's a comparison. Trinity test in New Mexico in July 1945, which ushered in the nuclear age, had a yield of 20 kilotons. Hiroshima's Little Boy bomb had a yield of 13 to 18 kilotons, whereas Nagasaki's Fat Man bomb had a yield of 20 to 22 kilotons of TNT. B-6112 is expected to have a dial-a-yield capability, which can limit the extent of the nuclear reaction inside the warhead to lower the explosive force. This way, a B-61 Mod 12 will be able to replace different bombs which have predefined explosive yields. The B-61 Mod 12 will also replace the B-6111 Bunker Buster variant. In 2014, former U.S. Air Force Chief of Staff General Norton Schwartz, speaking at an event at the Stimson Center think tank in Washington, D.C., suggested that the guidance kit on the B-6112 will enable it to destroy hardened underground targets without any specialized bunker-busting variant, as the blast's impact will be very focused due to the high accuracy. A total of 400 B-61 Mod 12 are expected to be developed. Apart from B-2 bombers, the bombs will be integrated into dual-purpose combat jets, such as the F-16 and F-15 Strike Eagle. The U.S. Air Force plans to integrate the B-6112 on the F-35A Joint Strike Fighter and future B-21 Raider bomber that will replace B-2. Viewers may note that a new nuclear-capable cruise missile is being developed for both B-2 and B-52 bombers. But the advantage of B-6112 is that more B-6112s can be carried by B-2 or the future B-21 Raider when compared to the cruise missile, and hence more targets could be neutralized in a single sortie. The bombers, as well as any smaller jets carrying the nuclear bombs, though being vulnerable of counterattacks, are an important part of America's nuclear triad, since this option offers much better flexibility. Bombers and fighters can shift target or abort mission entirely, even at the very last stage, when compared to missile-armed planes or sea or ground-launched cruise or ballistic missiles. Clearly, B-61 Mod 12 will be an important part of America's military going forward.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting. And kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.